Generosity is at its core a lifestyle in which we share all that we have, are, and ever will become as a demonstration of God's love and response to God's grace. In the midst of our failed attempts at loving Jesus, His grace covered us. If you fear to have written too many checks on God's kindness account, drag regret around like a broken bumper, huff and puff more than you delight and rest. And most of all, if you wonder whether God can do something with the message of your life, then grace is what you need. Divine grace, the fact that a perfect God truly delighting in mistakes, prawns people like me, is the wet soap of my theology. It's what compelled me toward Jesus, yet it's something seems to squirt right out of my grasp. The story of grace include a broad range of character, rich, poor, powerful, powerless. For all of them, it is God's grace that tips the scale in their favor. In some ways, these stories are our stories, for like the individuals who populate the passage pages of scripture, we to need grace, but not just any grace, the grace of God. What gives me the most hope every day is God's grace. Find God's goodness, grace, and comforting presence in our pain. We see God at work in our trial and can bring gold out of our affliction. Life is so much easier when I am aware of God's grace in my life. All the wonderful gifts I have been given and the people whom I have been blessed to meet and to know. The meaning of life, the wasted year of life, the poor choices of life. God answers the mess of life with one word, grace. Grace is a flow of the power of God through His people to accomplish His will among us. It is about His life manifesting in and among us.